Cyro from the film project here, and this is my cousin Jordy Turner, otherwise known as Cold Void 749.
Hi.
He helped me with the stop motion short film. Well, it was me, the musical. You can check that out in my playlist, Short Films and Plays or something. I forgot what I called it. Okay, so let's just start off. How's your day?
It's been good.
Yeah, that's not part of the interview, but you know, just curious.
It's been pretty fun.
So without further ado, let's get right into the interview. Question one. Do you like my haircut?
Yeah. I like the shaven bits on the sides. And...
yes. Yes. Thank you. It makes
it's
me feel
really
like
it's...
Question two. What made you want to start game art design?
Inspiration from other people's games, and like you look at it and you go, mind blown, I want to do it too. Like your head literally explodes.
Yeah. Question three. What game would you suggest as a masterpiece and would highly suggest it to the audience? Right.
I would recommend Undertale because it is a deep, immersive, and has a really good storyline.
Yeah, it actually is rated one of the best games of all time. So, there you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Play Undertale.
Okay, yeah. Question four. Before you scare me in your likeness of Undertale.
Yeah.
How do you think about the video game art and how do you think it stands out from other mediums?
Well, I'm a massive fan of video games. And I also like art and drawing and all that. So you smash it together and you get video game art.
Whoa!
Perfect match.
Whoa! Break physics. What is your theory on how video games are so entertaining?
Immersion. Like, how deep you get into the story. Because you get to know characters better. And you kind of get more feeling for them. Like... sometimes, like, bad guys, you're just like, oh, he's a bad guy. But then if you have an immersive game, it could be like, okay, he's like, he wants to be the ruler of the world, but he has mixed emotions about it, and you actually get to know the characters.
Yeah, I guess, yeah, that's good. My theory on how video games are so entertaining is that it takes people out of reality.
And yeah.
I mean, for some cases, it even helps with depression. And... so, yeah, it makes them think something they've never thought before.
Yeah.
It gives them new ideas, and they're just plain fun. I mean, like I always say, something new is something exciting.
Hmm.
I mean, that's the first time I ever said that in my whole life. I like the sound of it in the script, so I keep it in.
Anyway, next question.
Okay. Question six. What is your advice for other aspiring artists?
Okay, I know this is really cheesy, but keep on trying. If you fail, you might be like, I can never do this again. But do it. Yeah. It'll work out well. Yes. No matter how hard, no matter how bad or good you are, it'll work out well.
It works for me always as well. Like, if you just keep on trying, that...
there is no such thing as failure, only delayed success.
Yeah. Question seven, by the way, what is your goal on YouTube?
I'm gonna be honest, I don't really have a goal. If I were to do YouTube, which I likely will be, I would probably do it for the fun of it, not trying to be popular or anything. Because the chances of me becoming like a super million subscriber person is like...
yeah, I mean, same with me.
But that doesn't stop me! Never!
Yeah, sorry if this is a bit negative, but question eight. If you didn't succeed at your dream job, what other job would you take?
I would probably go into the area of more science or like developing technology or things like that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good. On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you rate your drawing skills?
Probably a 6. Because I see my drawings and I go like, yeah, they're alright. And then other people see my drawings and they're like, how could you draw that? I'm like, that's just one of my little scribbly drawings I do in 5 seconds. They're like, that is amazing, I could never do that. I'm just like, come on, I done that in 5 seconds. They're like, ah! Even for some of my worst drawings, people have gone, "You are amazing. Teach me your ways."
Yeah, yeah. I like that.
People have actually, someone's actually said that before. Teach me your ways. It's weird.
I like the cockroach with the new Fallout fan poster.
I've done a couple of Fallout 4 fan pictures. They're alright.
Yeah. So, question 10. What is the worst game you've ever played?
I don't really have the worst game I've ever played. Every single game on the planet has pros and cons. But if I had to say, I would probably say the game that I designed on the coding website Scratch. It was something like Hank the Virtual Monkey, and it was a virtual monkey pet that was really bad. Really bad. Play it, but don't.
Okay, well, it may be bad, but on Scratch, I programmed a thing called Psychiatrist Simulator, and I didn't finish it. So it's bound to be bad. So, yeah, same thing. Play it, but don't play it. Well, please play it, because I don't know what happens. But
don't worry. Forget we said it.
Okay.